Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Anna Karlsbauer, Isabel Hartwich, Germany. And on my left, Nicholas Moore, Sarah Clarkson, Denmark. Sarah Clarkson will serve, Anna Karlsbauer, Lovell.
A very good afternoon and welcome to this, the 101st edition of the Irish Open, the Carlton Irish Open, one of the oldest international tournaments on the European and global circuit. Fantastic afternoons, Edmonton lined up for you. Mixed doubles, as you can see on court, our first match. Representing Germany, number one seeds, Peter Kesbauer and Isabel Hertich. And the second seeds from Denmark, Niklas Nahr. Niklas Nahr and Sara Thygesen. umpire. From England, Alan Potter, and service judge from Ireland, Seamus. Furthest from the camera, the Danes in red. Nearest us, the Germans in black. The Germans have been so consistent on the circuit this season, but without a tournament win. We're runners-up at the Swedish Masters back in January, and that seems like a long time ago, and had several quarterfinals, semi-finals en route. And this, a golden opportunity at the end of 2014 to get their first victory of 2014 under their belt. Easy semi-final win over Harley Towler and Emily Westwood, 10 and 13. Breaking concentration, going, taken to three at the quarterfinal, losing the middle game against Ruben Gill in the lead at Chen. But that was the only lapse from the Germans this week. Danes, on the other hand, have come all the way through this tournament without dropping. Danes, unlike the Germans, have a certainly here. Went back to back with the Croatian international and the Dutch international. The week before that, runners up in the French international in Orléans. Semi-finals at the very beginning of this season in September at the Belgian international. Only 2 weeks ago, a Grand Prix level, the Scottish Open runners up.
7-6-3.
So without doubt, a form pair on the European circuit this year, Noor and Tigesen. Sarah, former Danish national champion, won that Danish national championship alongside Anta Skarp Rasmussen. Now, this firm partnership with Nicholas, really, at 2014 to remember. Well, the Germans are top seeds. I think the wise money will certainly be on the Danes to be favourites for this mixed doubles. Belief on the face of Isabel. Minor and Tigesen. Nicholas Noor. Big serve from Sarah. Oh, Isabel just looking a little bit nervous at the beginning of this match. And in just 5 minutes, it's the Germans, or it's the Danes, who have eased their way into an interval lead 11-4 and looking really relaxed, of course. Noor and Tigesen certainly well at home at international circuit, badminton Europe circuit, said already been in four this year, won two of them, so well used to winning, dealing with the pressures that come major in finance. The Germans.
20
seconds. Been in one final, as I said, this year, back in Sweden, the very first tournament of their 2014. To break that cycle. Superb play again from the Danes. Patient attack. Sara Tigesen certainly is comfortable in the rear court as she is at the net. Better rally that time. Germans. Just a little, looking a little bit nervy. We're on the attack, certainly in that rally, and had opportunities to get the shuttle down on the floor. Twice, once from Kasparov and then from Hertich, pushing it back flat. First game, a Danish pair.
So, 16-6.
Real error from Sara Tigesen. A frustration, Danish kitty. Germans will want to get a run of points just to try and get a rhythm going. The Danish pair have been utterly dominant in this first game, and that's another Kasparov. It's 10 minutes. Germans race the game point.
9:20.
Certainly this game most likely gone beyond the Germans, but it's an opportunity just to get some points on the board, and in the end, in just 11 minutes, Noron Thygesen race into a one game to love advantage, winning 21-10. Sarah Thygesen and Niklas Noor already back out on court. Danish team travel this week without a coach, working all the tactics out by themselves, which is sometimes a good thing. A little bit of independence, free spirit, opportunity to think through your own tactics along with your partner in singles, working it out for yourself. The Germans here with coaches this week. But it's certainly the Danes in the ascendancy. First game victory, 21-10. Small just leaving it for his partner. Guys on the attack from Noor. Yeah, beautiful play by the Danish man in the rear court. Delicate drop, taking the pace out of the attack. Hertic at full stretch and then coming in with the power smash. And then the smash again to the body of Isabel. Only separated by 5 places on the world ranking list. But right now it's the Danes who are looking a class apart in this mixed final here at the Carton Irish Open. Beautiful stick smash from Sarah Thygesen. As I said, so comfortable all over the court. One of the most improved players Europe over the last 18 months. Isabel is just looking a little bit on edge. There's no real pressure on the German girl. Flick serve from Nicklaus. A quick overrule by the umpire. Might see it on replay. Flick serve and then the smash down the line. Just out, I think. Difficult to call, of course, coming at you such quick speed. But a quick overrule by the umpire, and that's what you need. Strong umpiring. Superb serve. I'm sitting down that line, and that was a fantastic serve. This is where the mind game starts. Peter Käsbauer looking at the umpire for a judgment. He felt it was out, but certainly it was an excellent serve. In the end, a let call. That's the point he played. Danes really focusing a lot of the attack. Isabella Hertic. Again, drive into the upper body, proving a winner.
Six, one.
Just like the first set, Danes dominating this second, racing into a 6-1 lead. Variation in the serve, nor going out wide. Miscommunication, misunderstanding between the Germans. I think just getting a little bit lucky as the shuttle drifted out. Line judge called it out. Nicholas just asking the umpire.
Ready to play, please.
Ask the opponents not to try and influence the line judge.
Seven, two.
Now Käsbauer starting just to look a little bit shaky on the serve. Oh, beautiful serve and an equally good return from Isabel. Better rally that time from the Germans. Super serve out wide, but watch the footwork of the German girl. Body coming around. Sardines attacking the shuttle flat off the serve, catching the net. Good crouch defense from Isabel. Now, the variation from the Danes cross court.
8-3.
Smash from Tegas in cross court, and Noor, the left hander, following it up cross court to the backhand side of the right handed Isabel Hertic. Clash of rackets from the Germans. Even the communication breaking down now between Isabel and Peter. Really all the focus of the attack from the Danes going on to Isabel. Certainly the Danes hanging on to that rally from the outset off the serve. Nicholas Snorr getting very lucky after a super smash, then a miscommunication as you saw. But the Danes just keeping in there before the Germans finally getting the shuttle on the floor for the winner. One set down, 21-10 and 10-4 behind. You really start to feel that it's getting to do or die time now for the Germans. Cannot afford to let this gap grow anymore. Two-time 2014 winners, Moore and Degussen. Of course, that fantastic runners-up spot at the Scottish Open Grand Prix only 2 weeks ago. Going down on that occasion, of course, to Robert Blair and Imogen Bank here. The body language of Isabel, less than positive. At the interval, really, it's all going the way of the Danes. 11-5. Almost a carbon copy of the opening game where they led 11-4 at the interval. And then went on a crazy run, letting the Germans only in with 3 points in the remainder of that first set. This is a big
20 seconds.
Big few points now for Hertwig Käsebauer. Certainly Isabel looking a little bit susceptible on the return of serve. Almost looking nervous, of course. They haven't experienced that international win, that international feeling of winning a big tournament. Danes have. They're used to winning. They've done it before. Crazy to think that Noor and Tegesen went out in the very first round here last year at the Irish Open. Lots of world ranking points on offer for them today. One of those very, very rare errors from Sara Tegesen.
6-12.
Beautifully comfortable player, not only at the forecourt at the net, but on the baseline. So clever, so creative. Really just feeding off scraps in this match. One of the longer rallies of the match so far. Beautiful angle from Peter Käsebauer from the rear court. Now probably the best rally from a German perspective in this match. The excellent deep stick smash. That one from Peter. Getting nothing from it, of course. And you just feel the Germans starting to play a little bit better. Starting to relax. That's better net from Isabel. Just a final shot letting them down. It's all just a little, too late. The dominant Danes dictate all the play. Yeah, certainly. The apologetic hand to his partner, really. Dangerous ploy, playing a flick serve to the man in mixed doubles, especially somebody as quick as Peter Käsebauer. Confidence right now. There's a beautiful smash again from Tegesen. This time, better outcome for the Germans, finding the space in behind. Good defense from Isabel, and then good deception from Peter. Nicholas expecting the net shot. Käsebauer finding the space in behind for the winner. That's better. Isabel. And all of a sudden, Isabel Hertrich starting to tick.
9:15.
Maybe just a little bit late, a game and a half into a major international final when your opponents are leading one game to love and 15-9. Serve return. Game of Danes. Exemplary this week. Block defense from Tigerson. Right net, the German. Excellent rally of mixed doubles. Nicholas Knorr needing to be fully concentrated. The shuttle clipped off the net court. And in the end, three-quarter smash down the middle, proving the winning point. Really the best spell of the match so far for the Germans. Good rally. Again, Kesban Heltrich. Flick serve from Isabel, pushing Sara away from the net. Footwear alterations for Sahara. I love these little breaks in play sometimes. You know, Dane's certainly feeling that the Germans starting to gain some traction. Just a little break like this might be what it takes just to break their momentum. All part of the psychology of the game of badminton. Lift coming off the frame of the racket of Peter Kesbauer and an easy smash winner. Nicholas Knorr. The Danes just halting that advance, the Germans. The Germans winning 5 points from six. Super defense again from Sara Tigerson. She really had no right to dig that shuttle out from her head.
18-11.
Let's get this one here. Easy for her partner. 18-11. Oh, and this time, miscommunication.
Service over,
12-18. Sara certainly in control in that rally. So it really is now or never. Isabel and Peter. Kesbauer, Knorr, flick serve again. Again, getting in each other's way. cast iron point should have been for the Danes. Should have been a routine winner for Sara Teigesen. This one here, really no venom on it from Peter Käsebauer. The Germans just not going away, sticking at it, fighting hard. Only trailing by 3 at the moment. And there's another error, and all of a sudden the momentum seems to have shifted to the German side of the net. Crouch defense again for Isabel. Certainly has come into this game and this match in the second half of the second game. 6 points in a row on the serve of Peter Käsebauer, and all of a sudden it's the Danes who are just looking a little bit shaky, a little bit unnerved. As the Germans start up, they are looking for their first international win this year. Oh, misjudgment that time from Peter Käsebauer. Yeah. Resisting the urge to smack his racket off the advertising A-board. Peter, of course, got into a little altercation as a spectator here this week. The German-Danish men's doubles match. He was on the receiving end of a flying racket from the court. Big rally. This is surely, if the Danes win it, they will be favourites to go on and lift the title. If the Germans take it, they'll feel that they're in with a shout, and that's a poor drop from Isabel. Yeah, you can see the frustration on the face of the German girl. And it's match point, 3 match points for Teigesen and Noor. Angle, the steep angle on the smash from Käsebauer. And that's it. The Danes have done it. They've claimed the 3rd victory of the year. Sarah, the Snorer champions of the 2014 Irish Open. We'll be back with a quick interview with the players and then the men's doubles final next on court.
Here again, we've gone through the whole tournament. winning in two games, and that in itself is a huge, remarkable achievement. You must be really, really happy with the way you two have developed this last 18 months. In the end, Isabel and Peter started to come back, they started to relax and come into the game. You must have felt towards the end, I think about 1 or 5 points. It was a little bit shaky at one point.
Yeah, I think we had a really good lead in the second half. We both thought we were going to get closer, and I think they actually sent the backs that they wanted to play. The game was done. Always lost the fun there. I think we actually should calm down and relax a bit by ourselves.
Guys, once again, thank you for talking to us. Please, a warm round of applause for your champions. Give us more of Zara Davison.
Back over there, and then we'll bring your bags here. And we'll bring you here for the prize giving ceremony.
We have the prize giving ceremony shortly for the mixed doubles. Can you welcome back your runners up from Germany, Peter Käsbauer, Isabel Hertich. And your champions from Denmark, Sara Davison and Niklas Nord. Prize giving ceremony. Councillor for Fingal, giving the prizes to our runners up and our champions. And Sarah, once again, can I have a warm round of applause, please, for your winners and runners-up.